Okay, so in the previous videos we looked at center of gravity and then center of mass, and we introduced the centroid. Okay, center of gravity, remember for one dimension, x bar was equal to the integral of x dw over the total weight. Okay, that's the center of gravity, and we could do that for y bar and also z bar. But if gravity was, if we were independent of our gravitational field, then we could change this to the integral of x dm over the total mass. So this now is the center of mass. But then we also said, well, hold on, if density is constant, then we could change this to a centroid, x dv over the total volume. Okay, so we remove all density information and we're simply looking at the geometrical shape. This is called a centroid. Okay, now there's three specific centroids that we can look at: one for lines, one for an area, and then a centroid for a volume. Okay, so we're going to look at this in this video, these three. Okay, so how do we determine the centroid for a line? So an example is a slender rod of wire, a slender rod or wire of length L. So the length is L. So how do we determine out where does this guy come from? Okay, so let's go from first principles. X bar is the integral of x dm over the total mass. Now remember that dm, mass, remember, was equal to rho v, density times volume. And for the differential element, remember, we're always considering these differential elements. For differential element, this becomes rho dv. So it's the density of the differential volume. So we can replace that, x rho dv over rho v. Okay, because this is the total mass, so it's density times volume. And then if the density is constant, we can eliminate that already. But then what about what is the volume or the differential volume of a thin slender rod? Okay, so volume for this, for a rod, will be cross-sectional area times length. Okay, so if we have some kind of tube or some round bar, cross-sectional area times whatever length that is gives us our volume. And if the length is a differential length, dl, then we replace this with x area dl and divide that by the volume is area times length. So we've already eliminated our density because just if, remember, the thing is, if the density is constant, we can eliminate it. If it's not, you have to keep it in there. And the problem will, you'll be given density as a function of length, okay? Or a function of area or a function of volume. But our assumption here is that density is constant. And the next assumption is that because it's so thin, we assume that a cross-sectional area is constant. So areas cancel and we're left with this guy. Okay? For x bar, there's x bar. And we can do the same for y bar and z bar. And I don't know if I mentioned this, I don't think so, but the center of the centroid, okay? The centroid of this line does not necessarily have to be positioned on the body itself. It can be not on the body, right? Okay, so do you guys get that idea? What about the center of area, the centroid of a surface? Okay, so again, we can say x bar. Now we're looking at an area. There's our differential element, and there's our total surface. Again, we can say x dx dv. No. We can say, again, x dm over the total mass. That this is our center of mass, right? But if the density is constant, so the remember that is dv, rho dv, which then equals rho. In this case, what is our dv? It'll be the area, the differential area, times the thickness. That's the volume, right? So if that is my surface, that's my area. And then that will be my thickness T, okay? And so that's what they're doing here, density. So dm is density times the thickness times the area. And this TdA, right? TdA, that is my dv. And so we can put this in here, x rho TdA divided by m, which is density times thickness times the total area. And if your density is constant, we can cancel that out. If the thickness is constant, because if it's very thin, we can assume the thickness is constant, then we are left with this for the centroid of the surface area. And by the way, this is called a first moment of area. That's a first moment of area. Moment, we can just rewrite this like this, x dA. So in a sense, moments, don't limit yourself to thinking moments are just due to a force times a distance. The idea of a moment is, it is some quantity, some total quantity of something times a distance equals the sum of many quantities times their respective distance. Okay, so this is a first moment of area. So you can get y bar and z bar at the same time. Well, not at the same time, using the same idea. And then the last one is centroid of a volume or of a body. Okay, now I'm not going to go through this. I think you get the idea. Go through this and you can see again that the centroid x bar is the integral of x dv over v, etc. Okay, so we've got centroid of a line is x dl over l. Centroid of an area is x dA over A. And centroid of a volume is integral of x dv over v. Now, the next question is, what's going on over here? What is this dv? What is dl? What is dA? What is this integral we're talking about? What are all these little summations? Okay, and that's what we're going to look at next, the choice of the element for integration.